And now we will learn how to bill tenants for shared utilities. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Examples of shared utility costs are all tenants are under the same electric meter, the cable internet is paid by the landlord for the whole building, or water could even be billed under one meter. Why is it billed differently than repair or cleaning? Well, in this case, there's no specific event or service date that you wrote a check for. There is no specific check or bill that you can put on a tenant's invoice, like we did when we did repair and cleaning bill to the tenant. So what can you do? Well, if you agree with the tenant of the amount of utility charge that will be added to their monthly invoice, then you can create an item on the items list that will be added to the monthly rent invoice. And that item will be for that tenant's share of the utility. So remember we talked about the items list. We said, look, if you earn the monthly rent and you put that item on an invoice, the income account, rental income earned, should increase. And we even learned another example of items. If you put a late fee on an invoice, then the account in the chart of accounts that should increase is income from late fees. Well, then doesn't it make sense that if you put an electric charge on the invoice, that the account that should increase for that item should be income from electricity? Well, you could. You could put another income account called income from electricity, and then when you put the utility charge on the invoice, you can make that account go up, if you want. But if you do it that way, you would have to subtract out what you actually paid for electricity as an expense for the whole building in order to determine your real electricity cost. So that's not the proper way to do it. What is the proper way to do it? Well, instead of having the item connected to income from electricity, which is not right, you should instead have the item be connected directly to the electricity expense account, the main one. This way, when you pay electricity for the building, it goes up, but then when you charge the tenant the electric expense, it will decrease the overall electric expense at the moment you charge the tenant. Just like before, we click List, Item List, and the Items List opens. Now, from the bottom left, let's just make this a little bit wider so we can see the account. From the bottom left, we click Item, New, and this counts as a service. And we'll call this, with capital letters, Tenant electricity share. So we're charging the tenant $25 a month for their share, their agreed upon share of electricity. But the account that we connect it to is electric expense. So when we place this on an item, instead of an income account going up, it will be an expense going down. We click OK, and now let's take a look at an example. Let's imagine on February 5th, we paid the whole Peyton Place building electric bill, $100 to Con Edison. That's the electric company out here in New York. So let's go ahead and just do that. Now, before we do that, you may notice that there is no electric expense at all on the trial balance, because we have not used it yet here in the course. So let's go ahead and write a check. Let's make sure it says February 5th. And by the way, to make this course a continuous little story, make sure it's February 5th of 2020. Now, Con Edison is the electric company out here in New York. The amount we're paying for the whole building is $100, and the name of that expense is electric expense. Notice we do not put the customer because we are not putting this specific check on an invoice later. So don't put anything here. Just click save and close and notice that electric expense showed up for the first time in the trial balance as $100. Now let's imagine on February 28, we gave Freddy Froda the February 28 rent invoice, and we're going to add to the normal rent the $25 agreed upon electricity charge. That's Freddy's share of electricity. No problem. We open the invoice, and we know that this is the February 28th of 2020. And remember, this invoice is coming from, well, you have to check. If you go to the rent balances and go down to Freddy Froda, you can see Freddy Froda has a zero balance, so he didn't pay you the money in advance, which means this is going to go on rent receivable, because he has a zero balance. He did not pay February's rent in advance. Anyway, we choose Freddy Froda, and now we're going to put his normal monthly rent due. And if you forget how much the rent is for a particular tenant, again, you could look right on the rent balances, and you can tell Freddy pays what? It looks like he pays $1,000 a month. So we'll put $1,000 on the invoice. But now we have to add to the invoice the tenant's electricity share. And it says, is this is associated with an expense account? Yes, we do want to continue. We want the notice it remembered, by the way, the $25, because that's what we put when we set it up in the items list. You can't do that with a tenant's rent because everybody's rent is different. But you can do that if they all agree to pay the same electric share. So what will happen when we click save and close? If we open the trial balance, you see that the general electricity expense for Peyton Place has decreased by $25. And if we double click and open it up, we can see that originally we paid $100 on the 5th, but because we sent Freddy Froda an invoice for $25 for this particular expense, it went down. And if you go and you look at the rent balances specifically for Freddy Froda, you can see his balance went up not only by the monthly rent, but it also went up by the amount of electricity charge.